Now, a modern-day Sunday drive with our David Pogue.
Every year, 1.2 million people die in car accidents. But the drivers of these cars have made 5 million trips with no fatalities at all.
Never get fatigued, never get bored, never get angry on a phone call. We fundamentally believe that this will result in a safer driver.
These are self-driving taxis. Sashwat Panigrahi is the chief product officer at Waymo, the Google sister company that operates them. Every week, these AI drivers give 250,000 rides in San Francisco, LA, Phoenix, and Austin. Coming soon, Atlanta, Miami, and 10 other cities.
1 in 5 folks above 65 don't have a driving license. You know, 7 million plus Americans have vision loss. Our road shouldn't be a privilege for some and peril for others. And I think autonomous vehicles, we have believed from the get-go, can make the roads safer and more accessible for everyone.
I like that it's driverless. I don't find it intimidating. It's really great. I feel safe in it.
San Franciscan Steve Carmel is a fan.
How does it compare overall with an Uber or a Lyft?
The wait time for a Uber or a Lyft is usually much longer than it is for a Waymo. And the second part of that is that you don't have to tip the driver.
I never thought of that.
I hope I don't get a lot of hate mail.
Waymo has 1,500 cars on the road, all electric white Jaguars with a few modifications. These dark panels are radar, which can see through fog and rain. The spinny things are called LiDAR. They can see objects 300 yards away in all directions. And then there are the 29 video cameras, which can actually read what's written on traffic signs.
I mean, it seems like humans should be able to replicate this if we just had 5 or 6 of us sticking our heads out the roof facing different directions. We'd have the same safety record as the Waymo.
You would not have radar sensing around corners.
At this San Francisco maintenance facility, I thought I'd put those sensors to the test.
So these cars coming by, these are all autonomous.
Fully autonomous.
They're coming to park to charge.
Yes.
I'd like to do something that I didn't prepare you for. I'm going to be a clueless pedestrian on my phone. Wow! Yeah. A+.
Yeah. And did you notice, by the way, that it didn't wait until you were actually in front of it? It predicts what you're going to do next.
So what's it like to ride with Waymo's artificial intelligence as your driver? Well, spooky at first, because nobody's in the driver's seat. But overall, smooth and conservative. It always goes the speed limit, and it makes a full stop at stop signs. It gracefully passes parked cars.
That slows down.
Slows down for speed bumps. And pulls over for fire trucks. Getting a car to drive itself at all is an astonishing feat.
So it is brutally hard. The scale of it is just staggering. How would we react to that in rain? How would we react to that if it were snowing? How would we react to that if a truck was blocking our view of that?
I would imagine if you were to code all this, it's easy at the beginning. Stop at a red light, go on a green light. But it gets weirder and weirder. I mean, driving is totally unpredictable.
Absolutely. We see examples on Halloween of people dressed as large dinosaurs walking that we have never seen before.
You hadn't coded for that.
No, we hadn't. But now the system has learned that and is able to respond to that. So this Halloween, we're able to detect where impromptu trick-or-treating was happening and avoid those streets completely dynamically.
The difficulty of the problem explains why Tesla and Amazon keep postponing their robo-taxis. General Motors' Cruise service shut down completely in December after an accident where one of its cars dragged a pedestrian. Waymo is now the only robo-taxi service in the U.S., and even it's had some bumps in the road. There was the time Waymos honked all night.
The Waymo is stuck.
Or the time they had a standoff at an intersection.
Because the Waymo is trying to go behind the Amazon, but then it's stuck behind the Waymo, and oh my God, there's another Waymo. What's everybody gonna do?
Waymo haters, who consider the cars creepy and worry about losing jobs, have occasionally vandalized the cars or put cones on them so they won't move.
Your ride is booked.
It'll be here in 1 minute.
Okay, I'm gonna hit start ride.
Yeah, start ride.
Start ride.
But according to Waymo's consumer research director, Megan Neese, People are mostly just afraid of change.
Like anything, when you got something totally new, it takes a minute. Like sometimes people feel surprised or, you know, they need to adjust to that change. And
that's why when Waymo sets up in a new city, it spends months just letting empty cars drive around, so people get used to seeing them.
You kind of see, oh, it's just another car, right? And as you kind of see more and more of that, then we do see the acceptance of the technology go up.
I mean, there must be people who say, you're not catching me dead in one of those things.
Of course, yeah. We also see riders that are really inspired about it and then bring their friends or their relatives and just try it with me, Mom, you know? And so we see that, like, that also changes over time with experience.
Sashwat Panigrahi says that Waymo's cars have carried passengers 50 million miles so far, with 78% fewer injury-causing crashes than human drivers, and no fatalities.
Autonomous vehicles are reality today. They're not in the future. Tens of thousands of your fellow Americans are taking rides each day.
Steve Carmel is one of them.
All right, well, thanks, man. Have a good ride.
Thanks a lot.
And he's not looking back.
Drive safely, guys.
Okay, thank you.
Take care. Thank you.